One of the things that really drew me into the field of engineering is that pretty much any work that you do where you're trying to solve problems that helps to improve other people's lives. The last 5 years I've been working here at U of I to develop Blue Sabino, which is a robot that will allow us to do assessment and evaluation of stroke survivors and people with other neurological impairments. Most of us know somebody in our lives that's been impacted by the effects of stroke, and about 50% will have some kind of upper limb impairment they have to live with in their daily life. My role here, I'm getting to contribute to building this robot that we're going to use to make doing things like assessing stroke more possible, more doable, and just to build human knowledge of how do people recover from stroke.
This kind of work takes collaboration across many disciplines, requires collaborations across states, requires working with students, with professors, with engineers, with hospitals, with doctors. That sort of thing is the environment that we have at the University of Idaho, where people work together to achieve more than we can achieve individually. One of our main collaborators is Providence St. Luke's in Spokane.
30 years ago, the evidence was very good that if you train a human with enough trials, that you can have the brain actually regenerate, grow new neurons to be able to overcome the impairment from a stroke. And so devices like the device from University of Idaho are key to that, because you can allow a patient to have hundreds of trials in a single hour that you couldn't duplicate if you had a therapist that was sitting with a patient trying to encourage them to make a movement over and over and over again.
In the period right after a stroke, you're kind of in a race to get as much therapy time as possible, because your brain is the most plastic in that time, so you can recover the most quickly in that short period. Robots open up that possibility. We can get into doing things like measuring really precisely ranges of motion, the speed that people are moving at, how their individual joints move, and how much strength that they can exert on each of the joints. We simultaneously record the signals from the brain to the arm so that you can try and take a fuller picture of how a healthy arm works, but also how an impaired arm is working and how those connections are changing over time as somebody is going through therapy and recovering from stroke.
The field of rehabilitation robotics has been around for several decades now. There's been a lot of great work done, but there's also a lot more work that needs to be done to provide the best form of care that we can to people who need it.
In terms of doing the most good and working on something that makes the world a better place, I know that my contributions to this project is one of the best ways that I can be using my engineering degree.